Hi guys, it's me your teacher Belle and welcome to my channel. Kung bago ka pa lang sa YouTube channel ko, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell para maging updated sa mga discussion ko. For this video, I will discuss the core principles of fairness, accountability, and transparency. A good corporate governance in all businesses and even in non-profit organizations is very important in order to build trust and confidence with the investors, donors, and the community in general. And here are the three core principles of a good corporate governance. We have fairness, accountability, and transparency. Now let's discuss each of the core principles. For the first one, we have fairness. In the context of a business organization, fairness involves balancing the interest involved in all decision-making of the business. For example, class, in the hiring process, let's just say na may isang applicant na maitim, but the way na mamustura siya is formal, yan, presentable. And among those applicants, si applicant na maitim pero presentable naman is yung pinakamagaling. Kasi siya yung nag-top sa interview as well as sa exams. So, paano maya-apply yung principle of fairness sa example natin? Dapat i-hire ni business si Miss Magaling. Diba, hindi naman makakaapekto sa business yung pagiging maitim ni Miss Magaling. It is the capability of the employee that counts. Next core principle, we have accountability. When we say accountability, it is the obligation of an individual or organization to account for its activities, accept responsibility for them, and to disclose the results in a transparent manner. A good example for this core principle class is the work of the accountants, especially the auditors. Let's just say na may maling natuklasan si auditor dun sa financial statement. And this mistake class is due to fraud. Or sinadya talaga ng business na maliin yung data na inilagay nila dun sa financial statement. Kasi baka may pinagtatakpan sila, yung mga dirty secrets nila. Diba? At natuklasan nga to ni auditor. Okay, so nakay auditor na kung i-disclose niya itong nalaman niya or pagtatakpan na lamang. Pero kahit ano pa yung maging decision ni auditor, still accountable pa rin siya. Let's just say na pinagtakpan nga nung auditor yung anomaly nung business, well, madadamay siya dito. Kasi nga, the auditor is responsible. It is his or her obligation to disclose the results nung kanyang pag-audit. Last but not the least, we have transparency. When we say transparency, it is defined as being authentic. In the way an organization message themselves externally. Sa example natin kanina, yung auditor, it is the responsibility of the auditor to disclose the results of his or her work or yung ginawa na nga niyang pag-audit in a transparent manner. So, dapat i-disclose ni auditor yung totoong result ng ginawa niyang pag-audit. Kung may nakita siyang mali, dapat yun yung kanyang i-represent. Okay? Or i-disclose na nga na mali yung financial statement na ginawa ng business. It is the responsibility as well ng business na i-disclose yung totoong financial information dun sa mga users ng financial statement or ng financial information. So that is transparency class. The business must be honest, hindi lang sa kanyang nasasakupan or sa mga employees nito, sa mga staff nito, but also sa external environment nito, especially yung mga maapektuhan niya. And those are the core principles of a good corporate governance. So again, we have fairness, accountability, and transparency. Okay, so that will be all for this video. I hope you learned something from this discussion. But still, thank you for listening and see you on our next discussion. Bye-bye.